This is a Classic Hits 4FM podcast.
Should single mothers lose their benefits if they have more than one child? Now, I know that's a really harsh question. And I hope, well, one woman I'm going to speak to in a few minutes believes we should. And we should even go a step further. Earlier on today, I was reading through some stuff online about single parenthood, and I came across a very popular blog. And the blogger wrote an article that went viral. And I want you to have a quick listen. I'm just going to read this out briefly to you. I'm offering my solution to the problem of unmarried women having too many children. This is my sterilization for welfare plan. In order for a woman to obtain welfare benefits, she must obtain a freely provided tubal litigation. This is more humane than cutting off all welfare benefits entirely, because her unfortunate child will get welfare benefits. But the sterilization requirements prevents her from having any more children that the state must have to pay for. The woman has demonstrated irresponsibility by having a child that she can't actually afford. So tubal ligation seems like an appropriate punishment. When a woman shows up at a hospital to give birth without insurance or means to self-pay, this should be done automatically. Although this still means that the woman will be able to have one child before being sterilized, this suggestion will drastically reduce the number of welfare children born to single mothers. And after only a few generations, the problem of multi-generation welfare dependency will almost be eliminated. If one-child policy works for China, I think it'll also work for the United States, or indeed anywhere else. That's pretty heavy stuff, isn't it? I mean, from what I could see there, we got a huge amount agreeing with the bloggers, by the way, in the comments that I could see in the section below it. We have a situation in this country where it becomes financially beneficial to become a single mother. And that is in any Western country, in the USA or anywhere, that provides money for somebody to become a single mother, provides housing, provides benefits, handouts, as some people would call them. And then it becomes a vicious circle. And you've heard it, and I'm not going to deny that it happens. You've heard people saying there's generations of families who do this. Girl gets pregnant, 15, 16 years of age, just to get on the housing list. So tonight I want to know if you think more should be done to try and stop this culture of single parenthood in this country. And one idea that kept coming up was to stop child benefit and other welfare payments if the single mother has more than one child. I mean, it was revealed a while back that 23% of children born in this country are born to single mothers. That's a shocking statistic. That means there's no father in sight. We're not talking about separations here. We're talking about children that are born with no father in sight. Maybe they're not putting the father's name on the birth cert because they won't get welfare. I don't know. So we're not referring to somebody who got married, had three kids, and the husband left them. You know, he's a bollocks, you know that. We're not talking about that. We're talking about a woman who has a baby where there's no husband around. No partner, nobody. And the argument is that with generations benefit payments, that figure will only grow. Now, I don't want to have a pop per se at single mothers tonight, but there are countless research studies online which state that the vast majority of kids involved in crime are from single parent homes. I'm not going to go into that tonight, but that is the facts. So do the government need to actually do something to stop it, to stop the single parenthood? Or maybe you think things are fine the way they are. I want you to text 53544 or call us on 1850 410 494. And I want to ask you, do you think we should cut off benefit payments after the first child? That's the question. Yes, you believe they should. And I know they are going to do something, probably budgets on the way. Yes, you believe they should. Or no, you believe they shouldn't. So just text a simple yes or no, as usual, to 53544. If you want to get involved in the conversation, you can, by the way. The number is 1850 410 494. Well, one woman who decided something had to be done was a woman 2 years ago in California. She was a musician. Her name was Chapter Jackson. And she put a music video out on YouTube, which has gone viral. And it's called EBT. EBT, by the way, is electronic benefit transfer. It's the same thing. It's benefits. We don't have it. Well, actually, we do electronic transfer, don't we, over here now? We do, yes. This described how some people in California were taking advantage of the welfare system. And she described how some people abuse the food stamp system by having kids to get government benefits. Exactly the same thing that happens here. I'm going to play a little bit of the song for you. I will remind you it's after 9 o'clock. I will remind you to cover the kids' ears because there is bad language in it. All right, so have a quick listen. Listen to the words very carefully. She's not all for this, by the way. So have a listen to the words very carefully. It's an interesting piece of music.
Girl, what restaurant accept the EBT cards for the hot food? Jack in the Box, KFC, Subway, El Pollo Loco, Rally's Burger, most of the donut shops, the burger stands, Woody Barbecue, all the fish markets, some of the beauty supply stores on Crenshaw, and Rainbow on La Brea. You could buy you some clothes. How much you got on your EBT card?
Girl, I got enough to get it turned up. I done took the kids to the babysitter.
Which liquor store take the EBT card? Where y'all get that Patron last time?
Public service announcement. This is where the taxpayer money goes.
It's free! Swipe your EBT! Free! Swipe your EBT!
Free welfare, free dental, free food. Mama say she can't take me to school. Why am I hungry and we get free food? Free housing, free daycare, free clothes. This is where the taxpayer money goes. Ooh, a booger in my nose. We all share chonies and socks. Didn't mama check come in the mailbox? All you have to do is fuck. And 9 months later you're getting a big buck. But all you have to do is fuck. And 9 months later you're getting a big buck. All you have to do is fuck. And 9 months later you're getting a big buck. But all you have to do is fuck. And 9 months later you're getting a big buck.
It's free! Swipe your EBT! It's free! Swipe your EBT! It's free!
Well, there you go. That is a song. That is. I can't get into that there. I realize that is Chapter Jackson. Swipe your EBT. Now, the EBT, of course, is very similar to the social welfare card we have over here. In other words, you get your payments electronically, and you can swipe your EBT card. Now, she says there is all you have to do is you know what, and 9 months later you get a big buck. Well, I'm going to talk to Chapter Jackson. Chapter, good evening to you. Good afternoon. I don't know what time of the day it is in your part of the world. Hello, are you there?
Good afternoon.
Oh, it's afternoon. Yeah, it's afternoon. It is.
All right.
Hi, well, I have to say, a great piece of music, by the way.
Thank you.
All right, okay, we got a little bit of a delay going on, but we won't worry about that. Okay, Chapter, why do you bring out music like this? Obviously to express your own feelings. Did you come from a single-parent family?
I did. I came from a single mother, a single family, yes. Just with my mother, yes.
Okay, and how many children were there in the family?
There were 4 children in the family.
Okay. And what is it you believe is happening to the system in the United States, similar to the system over here? Do you believe it's being abused very badly?
I believe that it's abused very badly, and I believe that children are, you know, being taken advantage of because of the system. I believe that because of the system, children are being abused. The more children you have here, the more money you get, and you don't have to work, and the children suffer, like I did.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's pretty much the same way as it is over here. You know, you get more kids, you get a bigger house, you get more kids, you get more benefits. So the more children that you have, the more you're going to get, which discourages you from actually going out and getting a job. But what about a girl who's going to say to you, well, you know, she has a right to have children? This is what Irish women will say. I have a right to have a child. In the constitution of this country, it states that the constitution, the state will provide for my children if I can't provide for them.
Right. Here you can, you have, like you said, you can get a big house.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to work. You can get fast food. You get free medical, free dental. Tax credits, and the fathers aren't around, and the women don't really want the fathers to be around, so it promotes more children being born because, mm-hmm. you know, without fathers, and I don't think that they should be able to benefit from this type of behavior and to put their children at risk of all these different guys coming in and out their home, and that they're just being rewarded for just careless behavior.
Yeah, I mean, some of the texts coming in at the moment, somebody says, yes, why should somebody be rewarded for opening their legs, essentially? Of course, that is what your song is suggesting as well, that 9 months later you get a big check. Now, we don't get the fast food over here, but we do get all the other benefits that you mentioned, including free medical care, free dental care. We get everything else, of course, if you're in that situation. But, I mean, what is the solution then? What do you say is the solution? Just cut off the benefits? That would be a disadvantage to the child. Sterilization? That would be against human rights. So what is the solution?
Okay, the solution would be, my opinion, from my experiences, after the mother has 1 to 2 children and there's no father in the house, she has no job, she hasn't educated herself, it's a generation thing. She's in a house that her mother lived in or you know, her great grandmother lived in, and so this is a behavior that's taught. I believe that they should, I believe that if they're having children, they should be sterilized if they want to continue to get the benefit. It's a choice. If you do not want the benefits anymore and you want to continue to have children, you can have as many children, but the state is not paying for those children. You have to pay for them. And if you're not going to pay for them, then the children will be taken away from your care because the act that you're committing is child abuse. So you can have as many children on your dime, but not on the state's dime, in the taxpayer's dime. So you need to be sterilized to get more benefits, and you need to enter in some type of educational classes and get off after 5 to 4 years, because after that you're not getting a house, you're not getting a gas card anymore, you're not getting the free medical, the dental, it's your responsibility. You have children and it's your responsibility. That promotes real parents having children, rather than someone just having children just to get money, just make it a career out of it.
I know some people are going to say that's a pretty radical plan, and they're going to say that the word Hitler is going to be mentioned at some point tonight, I'm pretty sure of that. But in saying that, to me, it sounds reasonably logical, but where we go too far is where we start, you know, saying to people, if you want money to provide for your children, we're going to have to sterilize you.
Well, I think that it has to be aligned somewhere, because that's the choice. If you have 2 children, and, like, I didn't have a father. I met my father when I was 14 years old, and I met him at a prison. In prison, I drove all the way to San Luis Obispo in California to see him for the first time. I never met him before in my life. And my mother had 4 children and 3 different baby daddies. So that's a problem. And the children, how we were raised, we didn't feel that we were brother and sister. So something should have happened back then, and it was a lot of child abuse in my home. Something should have happened to stop her, and nothing helped. Nothing stopped her, and finally she got her tooth tied, my mother. Mm-hmm. But it was only because she figured that 4 kids was enough. She was making enough money, plus the money that she was making at home, like braiding hair and doing hair and things like that. But it was always a different man in the house, and I don't see how that's helping anybody.
All right, okay, it's a pretty radical plan. Okay, you've heard what Chapter said. Stay there with me if you can, Chapter Jackson. She's a singer-songwriter, and she expresses her views in song, as you heard earlier on. She's had a rough childhood. She was brought up with 3 brothers and sisters, or siblings. Her mum was a single mom, and she believes the only way to tackle this problem, which is a huge problem, and let's face it, I know we're not supposed to talk about it, but it is a big problem here in Ireland as well, where people have children for benefits and then get themselves in a cozy situation where they feel they don't have to work. And Chapter believes the only way to sort it out is, after the second child, maybe, or whatever it happens to be, bring in some sort of legislation where, yes, you can have your benefits, you can keep getting them, provided you're willing to have your tubes tied. I don't know what you think of it. If you think it's a good idea, text the word yes. If you think it's a rotten idea and there's something very, very wrong with it, you can text the word no to 53544. I want to just go to Tanya first, if I can. Tanya, how you doing? You're on Classic Hits.
Hey.
How you doing, Tanya? Well, you heard Chapter's song. It's a pretty good song, actually, if you like that kind of music.
Not bad, yeah.
Yeah. What do you think, Tanya?
Well, come here. No offense to the girl. I understand her background and her upbringing might be a bit... It was difficult, as she said. But I don't think any woman should have to go through that and have to put her body through something like that. just to not have kids because it's not fair to get benefits. I think the benefits are put in place just so you can make a better living for your children, or you can make life better for your children if you just can't do it yourself, if you're not working or whatever. They're in place for a reason.
And are you working?
No, I'm not working.
There's a surprise. And do you have, how many children do you have, or do you have any children?
Yeah, two.
You have two children, okay. And a boyfriend living with you, not living with you? What's the story?
Back and forth.
All right, okay. So they're coming and going, so to speak.
Yeah.
I think I remember telling you were on some time ago. You were telling me your boyfriend was a thief or something like that. He stole mobile phones for a living.
Yeah.
I do remember. Yeah. Oh, okay. I do remember you now. All right, yeah. Wonderful. Okay, so you disagree with Chapter completely because you think this would be against your human rights. So, in other words, you should be allowed just take from the state and not give anything back.
Well, I don't think that I'm just take. And, you know what I mean? If I have a child, that's a natural thing for a woman to do. But if I feel that I need that support, obviously I'm going to take it to make something better for your children. Do you know what I mean? And who's to say that we're having kids just to make the money? That's not how it is in my life. If I have a child, I'll do what I have to do to support that child. And no disrespect to Chapter. Like, she had her background, she had her life. And it might not have been a smooth ride at the time. And her mad done what she had to do. But for me, I feel if the offer is there for the support, and I can make it better for my family and for my children, I'm going to take it.
Yeah, but if there was an offer there for the state to give me, even though I'm working thousands of euro every year, of course I'm going to take it. Everybody would take it, but you just don't take advantage of the system. You are taking advantage of the system. You told me before, I think I remember rightly, you've never worked.
No, I didn't work, but this is all about experience in life. If you can't get a job because you haven't got experience, it means that your only option is to take that support being offered by the government. And if you have to take that support, you're being judged against it. And if you're taking the support to be there for your children and to make things better for your kids, I think it's a bit rude now, the fact that the offer is in place and the support system is there and you're told that you shouldn't be taking it. Could you take advantage? I mean, it's a bit like double standards, you know what I mean?
Well, Chapter, she's saying, well, if the state are providing this support, why shouldn't she take it?
Well, I feel like in life you have choices. Either you make a career or you can be a productive citizen, or you can choose the life of having children and gaining the benefits and things like that. It's a choice that you have to choose in life. Whatever makes you feel good.
So do you believe somebody like Tanya, who's now on her second child, she has her second child, as she said already, I don't know how many boyfriends or husbands or whatever they are, come and go. You believe that she should be offered the opportunity, or before she gets any more benefits, that she should have her tubes tied?
Yes.
Go ahead.
I don't mean to cut across you there, hon. I just want to tell you, I think over there where you're living, life is very high. Do you know what I mean? You're all making your money and it's a different story over here.
No, it's not a different story. It's not a different story. Hold on a second. Hang on. Let's clarify here for a Chapter who wouldn't be familiar with the Irish system. You're getting a rent allowance. I think you told me the last time, if I remember rightly. You're living in a house and you're getting a rent allowance, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're not paying for your own home, all right? So you've a three-bedroom house or whatever it happens to be. Your boyfriend comes and goes as he pleases. He's, as far as I remember, he's a thief. Okay, you've got two children who are paid for by the state. Both paid for the state. Everything is provided. You get back to school grants. You get your school uniforms paid for. You get everything paid for. And on top of that, you also get a social welfare payment as well on a weekly basis, plus a single parent allowance. Yeah?
Right. Hang on a minute, Niall. Before you go rubbing more salt into that wound, right? If I don't take any of those benefits and I can't get a job as a fact of not having any experience and not people just not looking for people to work, nobody's hiring, do you want me to leave my kids to struggle? Do you want me to leave my kids to suffer because you think I shouldn't take a benefit?
I'm not saying you should leave, but you don't want to get a job. You're cosy at the moment.
I'm cosy where I am now, but I've tried for years. I tried since I got out of school to try to get me work and I could never get anything.
So you figured the best way there was to have children so you would get a house then?
Child and the ball starts rolling from there, you're going to do what you have to do to survive. And we talked about that before as well, survival skills.
And
I have to do something for my kids, I'll do it.
And are you going to have another child?
Well, if it happens, it happens. Never say never.
Right, but you're not sitting there thinking of your economic situation saying, I can't actually afford another child, so if I do have one, the state is going to provide for it again because I have no intention of working.
But it's not with no intention, though.
It is no intention.
You have a child. But if you have... Who says I haven't got any intention to work?
Well, you said you were cozy. You said you were cozy at the moment. If you start work, you lose your benefits.
No, that's not it. No, you're right. You might lose benefits and all that. But who said I don't want to gain some kind of experience? But no one out there is willing to offer that kind of position to someone who's never worked before.
Okay, let me ask Chapter. What about women? And I'm sure it happens in the United States as well, Chapter, where women get themselves into what they call the poverty trap. In other words, they get themselves into a situation where if Tanya goes out and gets a job, she loses her benefits, or she could lose some of her benefits. In other words, she's in a situation where she's financially better off the way she is at the moment. Whose fault is that?
I believe it's her fault because we have to take responsibility for the actions and that we have to take responsibility for what we do, and that, you know, but in the United States, if you decide to get a job and you want to basically wing off, they do provide daycare for you. That's free of charge until you can wing off. But you can't get married here. You can't have a family. And so one thing that I would just want to tell her is that kids, they grow up. And so, like me, I grew up. I'm grown now. And I remember my mother having different men in the home. I always thought my mother was very intelligent. I just always wondered why she wasn't more. I knew that what she was doing was wrong, and I knew that I was a paycheck for her. I knew that because I was born, she lived in this house. Because I was born, she got all these benefits, and it didn't make me feel that good. In fact, it kind of, now that I'm grown, and sometimes I see my mother now, I just still have this thing between my mother and I, because I feel like she didn't have me for love. She had me for her own sake, her own selfish reasons. And so I just, kids remember the riffraff and the different guys and the fights and everything. The uncles, this is what we used to call them, the uncles. And so it's not right for the kids to have to endure something because you're being taken care of. You can have a roof over your head. But you could have went to college, or you could have done all these other things and have children. And sometimes it's hard. It is a struggle out here, but that's life. You have to crawl before you walk. And you know, it benefits to working and things like that. You know, but the kids, how do you want your children to look up to you when they're grown?
Does that not make sense to you, Tanya?
Yeah,
you know, and by your own admission, the last time, your boyfriend, you know, he steals phones and stuff like that, and you even said you sold some of them for him. Are you happy to see your kids grow to watch mom on the welfare, mom not doing any work, where's the work ethic, mom sells stolen mobile phones on the side to make a few quid as well, you know, and mom is being paid for by the state, and basically, as Chapter said, all we are is dollar signs, euro signs, whatever you want to call it, sitting here waiting to get more money.
Girl just said that, like, I'm having me kids and got me paycheck and I didn't have them out of love. That's totally the wrong way to look at it. I definitely have my children out of love, and I love them more than anything, but I don't see it as a paycheck. She might see it like that because that was her story, but by no means am I having my kids just to pay for how I live. And
but
also,
they are paying for how you live. But they are paying for how you live. If you didn't have those children, you wouldn't have the house. You wouldn't be getting 100. You'd only be getting 188 euro, which for Chapter is probably about $250 a week. That's all you'd be getting. You'd be getting nothing else if you didn't have those kids. But because you have those kids, you get a roof over your head. You get free medical care. You get everything else all along with it.
Well, come here. These benefits are available. I still don't think so. Going back to a woman having to go through all that in our body, I don't think that I should have to suffer something like that just to not have a child. I think I love my children and I do what I can with the benefit provided.
Should you be allowed to spend my taxpayers' money to keep springing out children as you please? Should you be allowed to do
but
that?
But if you want to, that's up to you to look at it like that. At the other end of the stick, how many thousands upon thousands of people in Ireland are taking those benefits? How many thousands?
Oh, yeah, Tanya, I'm not suggesting you're the only one.
I understand that, but I think that it's a totally different argument. The offer is there, the support is there, the benefits are there, and if I think that my child is struggling, or if I think that I could provide more for my child by accepting that benefit, I'm not going to say no.
Okay, well, hang on a second. I'm talking to Chapter Jackson, who's a singer-songwriter who believes that women who have more than two children, obviously if they're single, we're not even talking about people who are together, for example, should have the availability to be sterilised if they want to continue having more and getting the benefits. I want to go to Richard. How are you doing, Richard? Stay there, Tanya. Richard, you're in Clare. You're on Classic Hits. Good evening to you.
Good evening. How are you doing?
How are you doing, Richard? I know it seems like a pretty harsh solution, doesn't it? I mean, to sterilise people. No, it doesn't. Oh, okay.
No.
Why not?
Chapter is dead right.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think it's the lack of experience that is preventing Tanya from getting a job. I think it's more the lack of a brain. But anyhow, it was once said by an intensive care nurse in one of the children's hospitals to me a long time ago, and it is so true. If women needed anything from the neck up to have children, we'd be an endangered species.
I'm not even going to comment on that, but go on, keep continuing what you're saying.
So, there was another discussion on here, and I was talking to you before, and it was in regards to children's allowance.
Mm-hmm.
And I think
child benefits,
the solution
yeah.
is that the government can make an announcement tomorrow that as of from in 10 months' time, there is going to be no children's allowance, no single mother's payment, child benefit for a third child. So if you have three now, you're going to get them paid for. If you have four now, you're going to have them paid for. If you have one now, you'll be allowed a second one. But if you have a third one, you get nothing.
Well, they are actually going to do something like that, but they're basing it on age. But hang on, Richard. It's all well and good to say that. The problem with doing that is that the person, or the biggest disadvantage to that is the child is the one that's going to suffer. So if some mother goes out, like Tanya, and has another child in a year's time after they bring in that legislation, that child will suffer. Tanya won't.
Correct.
The child will suffer. That's not fair.
So you send in social services and you take the child from that situation, and there's going to be the probability next year of with this gay marriage referendum, that and they're going to be looking to adopt children, we can adopt them out to those. Now, look,
take the children off them if they have a third child.
Absolutely, yeah. If they cannot look after the child, if they are not, you mentioned earlier about having children being a human right. I don't believe it's a human right. It's a privilege, not a right. And if you can afford the privilege, then you go ahead. If you can't afford to bring a child into the world, look after it, rear it, educate it, and give it a good start in life, you do not have the right to bring a child into the world.
Well, there you go, Tanya. There's somebody different singing a different song to yours anyway.
Yeah, he's definitely singing a different song. Come here, can I tell you something? This is an assumption that all youths have. I assume that they don't look after their kids. I assume this, I assume that. I provide the best for my children, and I love them unconditionally.
No,
I never
don't,
bring them
Tanya.
Into the world.
No, you don't.
Sorry, what?
You do not provide for your children. You do not give them anything. The state provides you with the money so that you can look after your children, so that you can feed your children, and so that you can look after them. You are not capable of doing that unless
you
the state
tell me I'm not capable.
You to do it.
They're my children that I'm raising. No matter where the support is coming from, I'm still doing the best I can
it
do for them.
It doesn't matter where the support is coming from, because if you didn't have that support, you would not be able to look after them. You would not be able to educate them. You would not be able to clothe them.
Thanks be to God that I have the support.
Well, we're
that I can do the best for the children.
Looking to have it taken off you.
Well, keep looking to have it taken off you. Until then, I'll do what I have to do for my children, right?
Oh, we know that. And you will spit out more. Like, basically, what the taxpayers' money is doing in this country is spawning a subculture of morons and criminals.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You call me a moron?
Yes.
Sorry, you want to say something there, Chapter? Go ahead.
Well, my mother always told me she loved me, too. She told me she loved me. She loved her babies. She always would say that. And it's not, I don't doubt that Tanya may feel that she loved her children, and she may love them. I don't know. I'm not in her shoes to know if she loves them or she doesn't. I don't see how she's raising. I don't know. I just know what she's speaking, and from what she's saying, I can testify to this because I have experienced this.
it's not just something that I'm stating. This is my truth. This is what I've seen. And so I know for a fact that if my mother did not get a check for me, I would not be here. I would not be here. If she didn't get a check for me, if they stopped giving her a check for me, she would have gave me away. I know that for a fact. So I just, you know, it's just, it's really hard to hear, and it seems like we're beating on Tanya, beating her up and stuff like that. But I just feel that she's only speaking what she knows. You know, I don't know if maybe her mother did this or before, I don't know. But I know that my mother did it, and I know that my great-grandmother did it, and I know my grandmother did it on both sides. So it's a generation thing. And so it just, it creates people who feel like everything should be free for them. And they take it seems that they take no accountability for their actions. And so that's a problem, and that creates criminals and things like that, like my father. You know, he never took any responsibility. He's a lifer in prison. My mother had me from, you know, I came out of that situation. And my brother, my older brother, he's a moron, if you really want to. Mm-hmm. And a rapist. He raped me. I mean, my mother's children, we didn't feel like we were really brothers and sisters. My brother would rape me, my half-brother. And we didn't look anything alike or anything like that. We had no love for each other. So that's a problem and then we see these types of things. We see sex because all of these men are coming in and out of the house. So it just becomes, it's like an environment, and it's just a life of no responsibility. Nobody wants to be accountable. It's just, it's not productive.
It becomes, as Richard said, it becomes a different culture. I want to just take a quick break, and I have a lot of people want to come on. I know Barbara's been waiting ages as well. We are talking to Chapter Jackson, who is an American singer-songwriter who's expressed her feelings in song. And her feelings are in relation to the benefit system that they have in America, and they have exactly more or less the same benefit system over here. The song is called EBT. And that's, of course, refers to the American system of electronic banking transfer or benefits transfer. We have the same thing over here. We get our benefits transferred into your bank account, or you go collect them, whichever it happens to be. But she's referring, of course, to single mums. And this, what Richard described, is a subculture. And we're not talking about mums, by the way, who have been abandoned by the father and left with the children. That's a very different situation. 23% of mothers or babies born in this country last year. We have the highest rate in Europe. 23% of babies born in this country last year were born to mums with no boyfriends in sight, no fathers in sight, and no name on the birth cert. So we do have that subculture, if that's what you want to call it, in this country. And many people believe that some women do this for the benefits, purely for the benefits. And as Chapter said, it's a generational thing. It does happen in generations. This lifestyle, this social welfare lifestyle, this benefits lifestyle. And Chapter believes the only solution to it is pretty radical. It's to come along after the second child, and Richard goes along with that, to come along after the second child and say, well, if you want to continue getting benefits, you need to have your tubes tied. Because the state is not going to keep providing for every child you pop out. So do you think it's a good idea? Yes, you do. Or no, you think it's a dreadful idea. I want to hear your thoughts. You can text us at 53544. Or indeed, you can call us if you want on 1850 410 49. Barbara, how are you doing? You're on Classic Hits.
Hi, how are you?
How are you doing, Barbara? What do you want to say?
Well, I don't know. I don't agree with the tubalgation. I think it should be a choice for a woman, no different than, you know, I don't want to mention, I know the word abortion.
Mm-hmm.
People should have their own choice. Now, I understand there's a lot of problems, and there's a lot of single parents, and which is obviously, there's always been single parents, but it's become very rampant because now, you know, before if you got pregnant out of wedlock, you know, it used to be, get the gun shot out and mm-hmm. to the church.
Get married,
around,
yeah.
Get
yeah.
married.
Mm-hmm.
But nowadays, nobody bats an eye whether the kid's got a, you know, under the roof of marriage or not. And so, see, the culture has come in, and it's like anything that changes. It's hard to stop it now that we've allowed it.
But we encourage it by paying
for it.
But
that's what I'm saying. But I don't, I mean, I understand there's, you know, single mothers might have 3 and 4 and 5 kids, but there are people that have a child not planning to, you know, accidents.
That can happen. That can happen. And that's why we say two children.
I understand if they keep going and doing it on purpose, but how do you decide which one is an accident and who's
when you get to the point where you have 3 kids for 3 different fathers, for example, I had a woman on the show a while ago and she had 5 kids for 4 different fathers. I mean, surely there's something amiss there. And one of the children she had while she was homeless with 3 of the children. Wow. I mean, that's crazy. And she's on the front of a newspaper looking for a bigger house from the state. I mean, at what point does somebody say, I need to have some sort of financial stability before I can bring a child into the world?
My life and my husband's life, we never asked for anything. And we have a large family. And we struggled many times. But we never looked. When we first moved back to Ireland 30 years ago, we were shocked that you get child allowance.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and because we were not used to handouts. Now, I know America always has had welfare, but I didn't realize how rampant it got over there, to be honest with you. I knew there were families generations, that was just their way. But I didn't know you could go on welfare very easy. Course, we never look to.
I want to ask Chapter that. Chapter, I mean, living in, you're in California, by the way, aren't you?
Yes.
Okay, ironically enough, by the way, there was an ad there for our competition tomorrow. We're giving away a trip to California. But so you're in California. How rampant or how widespread is this abuse of social welfare, particularly by that section, which would be the, you know, mums having 2 and 3 children?
It's very widespread. Mm-hmm. It's out of control. In fact, you talked about the shelter here. If you don't have a place to live and you have 4 to 3 children, you just go to a shelter, spend the night, maybe a month or 2 weeks, and you automatically get Section 8. Otherwise, you have to get on the waiting list here. But they'll give you free housing and everything. But it's very widespread. Some people are very flamboyant, like, you know, out of with it, you know, excited about it because it's on a card now, and it's like just swiping a credit card, and then some people are, you know, ashamed of it. But most people here, especially in Los Angeles, they're excited, and the kids that turn 18, they're really excited about it. They run out and get a EBT card, which is in the state, in the United States, it's called the EBT card, and it just gets their brain going. Oh, everything's going to be free now. So, yeah.
So I can live on the social welfare, as we call it. You call it benefits. We can live on the social welfare for the rest of our life, nice and cozy. Sure, what's the problem?
Yeah, and never have to worry about money. Never have to worry as soon as I can get pregnant. Like some children have children at 14.
Mm-hmm.
They make deals with the fathers. Okay, if you get me pregnant and then I get a house, you can live here for a certain amount of time. I'll give you a little bit of money, and then you go and get your welfare, too, and they don't even know that you're the father. So we can. It's just the whole system here. So it's crazy.
I mean, we talked to Tanya before in the year, and that's exactly, Tanya, with the greatest respect, that is your situation. You had 2 fathers for the 2 children that you have. Both your father, the guys that were the father's child, neither of them were working. Both were on benefits, living with you illegally because you're not allowed to do that when you're getting a house from the state. So, Tanya, there's nothing to encourage you, Tanya, to go get a job. Why would you want to?
Like, people think this is an assumption that you're all making, and it's an assumption that everybody makes, that somebody who gets these benefits has no drive or has no goals in life. Who are you to say that I don't try? Do you know what I mean? And maybe I do try, but there is an incentive for me to want to get better. And it's not to say that I won't direct my children and make them do better than I did in life. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, but you told me a few minutes ago, if another child comes, so be it. I can remember, I'm not coming across as Mr. Goody Goody, but I remember getting married and we made a conscious decision not to have any children for 3 years because we wanted to have a holiday. We wanted to do those things that you do, you know, when you're single, so to speak.
Do you have that money now?
No, hold on. Wait for a second. The very reason we didn't have a child immediately was we wanted to save up for a house, which we eventually got. It took us a long time to get there because it wasn't that easy 30 years ago. We wanted to get a house. We didn't have the money. I didn't have the money to go on a holiday that year. and also provide for a child. I didn't have the money to do it. But to you, Tanya, it's not a thought in your head. You decide, I'll have a baby. Sure, it doesn't matter. The state will provide. They'll give me a bigger house. They'll give me more benefits. It doesn't matter. The state will just provide for me. And meanwhile, I can go out with my thief of a boyfriend and sell mobile phones.
No, but come here, you think that because I get these benefits that I'm living in a massive massive house and I'm living in a lovely decorated place and all.
You're living in a three-bedroom house. Hold on. You're living in a three-bedroom house, which is more than many people who are working can actually afford to buy. And you're getting it for nothing. You get it for nothing.
Sure, everyone's situation is different. Do you know what I mean? I'm going to say it again. It's an assumption either I'm making. Like, I can make this happen for my children if you, like, accept the fact that I'm just taking the benefit to support them. And if I help them go in the right direction, and if I need the support of the state to do that, then I'm going to do it.
All right, well, hold on. Some of the texts coming in. Somebody says, no, there are 38 million people living in California. Los Angeles is hardly a representative of the state at large in the territory of Western Europe. Well, I have to be honest, I think Ireland is very representative of what's happening over there as well. I want to go to Tom. How you doing, Tom? You're in Limerick. You're on Classic Hits. How are you doing, Tom?
Niall, how are you tonight?
How you doing, Tom? What do you want to say?
This crap with people here in Ireland. With this
can you do me a favour, Tom? Can you pick up your phone and take it off speaker because it's really difficult to hear you?
It's not on speaker. Is that better?
Okay, that's a little bit better. Go on.
I'm sick of people in this country thinking they have a sense of entitlement stuff. I'm working three jobs. I barely get to see my wife and child 5 days of the week. Because I'm working on average 12, 14 hours a day to provide for them. I get nothing from the state already, except for the children's allowance, which every child gets in this country. Mm-hmm. I am totally shit sick of all these excuses. I'm not going to have a go at Tanya because I was on before and I don't have a great opinion of her, but look, it's not for me to judge, but I would be quite honest. She's on about getting work and this, that and the other. There's farce out there. There's loads of courses that she could have done, loads of opportunities she could have given herself, except she's too bloody fucking lazy, which is the same story with a lot of them.
You just said you're not going to have a go at Tanya and you call me too bloody fucking lazy. Who are you? Who are you, like, out working at three jobs?
Yeah, I have to be working. Because I have to pay taxes, which keeps you sitting on your arse.
No, that's not how it is. Come here. What we're talking about here is women having to go sterile so they don't have children. You're a man.
No,
you can't say anything like that. You don't have to go sterile to not have kids. I'm not going to put my body through that.
I'm not asking you to get a sterilisation or something like that. But I'm sick of this sense of entitlement that people have in this country.
I think you're finding the wrong person. Because if the offer is there, you can't judge the people by taking it.
The root of this problem is the mentality of people. You have two kids, God bless them, I hope they're healthy and happy and all that, okay?
You definitely are.
Yeah, well, that's good, I'm delighted with that. But when you have one, did you not think, okay, maybe if I want to try and get out of this vicious circle, which it is, I might just leave it at one for now. Because, believe me, there are plenty of birth control options. Believe me, I have one child. I cannot afford a second child. I'd love to have a second child, but I can't afford it because the state won't provide for me while I'm working. It's very easy to talk about stuff like that.
It's very easy for it to be said. But they're only words, let me tell you.
Tanya, it isn't very easy when you're working 12, 14 hours a day and you get to see your daughter in a passing glimpse. You might get to see her one day on the thunder.
I'm very sorry to hear that. I wouldn't say that on anyone's situation, and mine is different.
Yeah, your situation is because you've taken the easy option and decided, oh yeah, let the state provide for me. Plus, you
are
also
making assumptions.
Am I making assumptions? Is the state paying you a single parent allowance? Are they paying you children's allowance? Have you got a medical card? And have you got rent allowance for a house?
That all might be fact. Well, the little sly digs that you're throwing in there, don't be getting smart. My situation is different, right?
No, I'm asking you a question. Are you receiving those benefits?
She is.
Yeah, I am.
Right. Okay, so you are. So why don't you do something to get out of it?
And can I reiterate too that her boyfriend she mentioned the last time on the side is actually stealing and she's selling stolen mobile phones. She admitted that before.
Again, we're rubbing salt into the wound.
I'm just putting out the facts, Tanya.
It's actually the truth.
I'm just putting out the facts.
You admitted it yourself. So don't come along with this crap and say, oh, poor me, poor this, poor that.
I didn't say poor me. I'm just saying the victim. I'm doing what I have to do, like I said already.
I'm doing what I have to do, but I'm doing it properly. At least my daughter will see a good example.
Well, fair play to you. I'll give you that pat on the back, pal, but don't be all making judgments.
I'm not making judgments. In fact, you're receiving all these benefits, yet you're doing nothing to change your situation, which you can do. You can actually go fast. I'm sure there's childcare in the area where you're living that you can get, because there is free places for kids, as far as I'm aware now.
There is, yep.
So you can do something.
She doesn't want to.
Well, whether she doesn't, like, if she wants, the only one that can affect the change is herself. Do you know what I mean? Like, I don't have a choice in this now. I have a wife and daughter. My wife is at home. She's looking after my daughter, the best ability. She's working 24/7 with the child. I'm not working then 5 days a week, and six if I can get it. Working between three jobs. Do you know, like, I'm not the only one that's doing that. There is work out there if you're willing to work. I'm in low-paid jobs, that's why I have...
So what are you saying? Tanya's just not willing to work. She's just not willing to contribute, that's what you're saying.
Well, you see, that's what's wrong with this country. Everything is too easy for people to get.
It's a very bad line. It's very difficult to hear you there. Well, but wait there for a second, and I'm sorry for keeping Chapter for so long as well. And Chapter, if you do want to speak at any time, your line is up there. You can say anything you want at any point.
I have a question for Tanya. It seems that she's fighting right now for the free thing, you know, and she has a lot of energy and she's passionate about it. And I just want to know, I mean, what does she expect her kids to inspire to be when they're older?
Well, Tanya, do you want to answer that? What do you expect your kids to be when they get older?
It's not what I expect them to be. Like, my kids will be what you want to be. Like, when you grow up with a child, you have all these different dreams and ideas and hopes for when you get older. I mean, if I help them get on the right path and I help them be able to fend for themselves as you grow up, I mean, they can do whatever they want in life. I'm not going to stop them from doing that. But for someone to think that my current situation is going to prevent my children from being whatever they want to be, That's a bad move. If you look at that girl right there, fair play to her. She's doing a great job. A singer, a songwriter, living her up in LA, and she had just as bad of a background. It's not worse. No disrespect. Do you know what I mean? So let's not judge her book by its cover.
Yeah, but I'm pretty sure, Tanya, she would change that background if she could. She would give up anything that she's making now to change the background. You did hear her say that she was raped by her own brother.
I did hear her say that night. I definitely did, and it kind of hurt a little bit. I wouldn't wish that upon anyone. I wouldn't wish that on anyone, and I tell you now, look at where she is today and look at the background she has. So let's not think that because of my situation that my kids won't go far in life, because I can guarantee you they will.
I just want to ask Tom, because Tom had mentioned something too about it. Tom, do you believe that Tanya, I suppose, is a good role model for her children?
I'm not one to judge. I'm not going to judge anyone with regard to her kids, but she's in a vicious circle there of what I call the social welfare. I don't know if it's a trap or if it's a comfort zone for her. That's for her to decide. But look, at the end of the day, and I'm 39 years of age. I'm at work since 5 o'clock, delivering fucking pizzas till 1 or 2 in the morning. I'm doing this 5 nights a week, and I'm holding down 2 hours as well. Do you know what I mean? Like, so I get home at 1 or 2 in the morning, and I'm usually gone by about 9 or 10 o'clock, which is like 2 years in the country working before you can claim off the social welfare or something. Now, that's fine. I've no problem with that. I left the country. I took that decision. And I came back for personal reasons with my family. But look, at the end of the day, I'm sick of people saying, oh, there's no work there. There is work there if you're willing to work. That's what pisses me off with
you. But hold on for a second. But you're missing the point. Tanya doesn't want to work.
Well, then, I'll tell you what. The social welfare system then should be adjusted to where she has no other choice but to work. There is free childcare places. There is none stopping her, whether she's on the social welfare or not, of actually going on a bloody forest course and giving ourselves more opportunities. There's nothing stopping her. The only thing that's stopping her
for a second, hon. See that free childcare? If you ever go in and ask for free childcare, you'll always read at the bottom of the page, terms and conditions. Well, that always applies. You're not going to get what you're told.
Hold on,
you'll always pay for it.
Tanya, you're not going to...
...your voice that you're fighting for it. And here, people have more children than just two. They have six, they have seven. My grandmother had seven kids and by seven different dads. So, what did Tanya inspire to be before she had these children? And she's getting free daycare. And I'm just saying, there's even college classes that you can take online now. So you can actually get a degree by staying home.
So what were your dreams and things like that? Because it seems that you have passion. You know, you're very good at arguing, maybe a lawyer or something like that. But, I mean, I hear things in you. And, you know, you're very passionate. So what did you aspire to be? Because it seems, and why couldn't you do those things before you decided to go the other route? Or is it something that you were taught? I don't know. You know?
No, it's not what I was taught. It's not something I learned. It's just my family situation. Like, we didn't have money down, but that made me comfortable. Then we had children, and then I started getting benefits, and it helped me raise my kids the best that I could because I couldn't do it any other way. I hadn't got the money, but my dreams, I wanted to get an education. I wanted to do the best for myself, but that all fell apart because my family weren't able to provide for me.
And was it the fact that you got pregnant that put a stop to your dreams?
It's all about the money. Yeah, it's all about the dollar at the end of the day.
Well, then, Tanya, why are you continuing to stay in the same trap? Why are you saying things?
You've said it yourself. You took the words right out of your mouth now. It's a trap, right?
Yeah, but hold on.
Your corner there. I'm gone.
All right, okay. Go on, Tanya. If you don't want to talk about it, go on. I want to go to Kathy. Go on. Kathy, you're in Carlow. You're on Classic Hits. Go ahead.
Hi, how are you? I've just been listening to Tanya's story and everything else there. I'm a single mother. I'm a single working mother, and I'm just on my way home from uni tonight, and I'm listening to Tanya talking about staying in the comfort zone in benefits and everything else. I mean, you know, her first stop for inspiration to get out and go to work should be looking at her kids and the example that she wants to set for her children. My son is 11 years of age. I'm 35. I could have very easily fallen into that social welfare trap. But the first time I went to sign on to social welfare, I was absolutely mortified. And I went home and I cried to my mother and I said, never again am I going to ask somebody to support me. And since that day, I never have. I've put myself through college and put myself through uni, and I supported my son in every way possible without taking a claim from the state or any benefits. And the likes of Tanya, I can see how easily they fall into the trap. But I mean, if they look at their kids and look at what future they want to show for their children, you get experience by going out and working for experience. And I mean, for sterilization, sterilize the benefits.
So you wouldn't agree with Chapter Jackson what she's saying in America, what they should do is tube ligation, which is, I suppose, tube ligation
for
sterilization.
Well, I think you're going to come across that the human rights factor onto that, but I definitely think for these people that are going, and I know people that are out there that have 3 and 4 kids and living off the state and everything else. I mean, if you discourage the payments, I mean, it's very difficult to support one child when you're working. I couldn't imagine.
Yeah, but if you discourage the payments, I'm not suggesting we do tomorrow. We say, oh, we're only going to pay for one child from now on, because then we have thousands, we have millions of kids in the country who are going to be affected by that. But what Tom and what other people are saying is, if you discourage the payments, people might think about it twice before they do it the next time. In other words, somebody won't be having 3 and 4 children.
Yeah, I mean, it's difficult to support one child when you're working without having to support a second or a third child. When you're claiming benefits, I mean, I don't know what they're getting paid now on benefits, but for 3 and 4, if they're getting free houses and electricity and healthcare and everything else, you stop all of that after the second child. It'll definitely discourage them from having 3 and 4.
All right. Somebody texts in, by the way, and says, Niall, I'm absolutely sick. I'm a single parent myself, and I've got 3 children, 2 different fathers. The relationships just didn't work out. Unfortunately, I am now in that trap as well. I haven't worked, and I find it very deeply offensive that somebody would even suggest sterilisation. Well, I if you want to come on the air and talk about your situation, you can. The number's 1854-10-494. Chapter, I mean, is it deeply offensive? I mean, what was the reaction you've had in America, say, for example? I know you've been on a couple of talk shows, etc. What's been the reaction to you saying that?
I think some people are very angry with me. They feel that I'm, like, telling the world how to scam the system and, like, basically telling on them, and they feel they're very upset with me. And then there's others that feel like it should have been exposed a long time ago. People need to speak out about it. And there's others that really, they become violent because that they feel like they're fighting for their rights. And so I believe it's 3 different sides, but it's split in the middle. you know.
Because there is, I mean, women out there like Kathy, for example, who are willing to get out there, get a job, support their own child. You know, and I'm not saying, by the way, that there is circumstances where the state has to provide for people, and that's understandable. I mean, there's loads of situations like that where, you know, people are genuinely in need, and that's what the state is here for, to provide for people. But clearly what you're saying is there's people out there who are just abusing the system purposely for their own benefit.
Yes, I'm for people. Like, I had an EBT card when I went to college for about 6 months, and then I decided to start working because I was getting my units to be a preschool teacher. And so I started working, and I didn't want it. It made me so bad. It just, I didn't want it. But I definitely didn't want to have any children because I could barely take care of myself. So I just, and I saw my mother do it, and I just, and all that. So I'm not talking about people who, I mean, in the United States, if you don't have any children, it's no need to really get on the system because you're not going to get that much money. But if you have children, then you can get on the system and you'll make a living. But if you're just single, you're not going to get any money from that. You can't have a career with it. So it's...
Mm-hmm. Well, it is a career for some people, Chapter. Actually, hold on for a second. Lots and lots of texts coming in. Somebody says, by the way, that poor girl got bullied off the air. She almost in tears. Well, she actually was in tears. You could hear her voice break. And one thing I have to say, Niall, is when people are on about Eastern Europeans getting benefits, you're always the first one to say, to blame the government for giving it to them. You can't expect them not to take what's on offer. It's the exact same thing here for Tanya. It's offered and she's taking it. Would you blame her? Read this out, you condescending prick. All right, well, I would say the same about you, Texter. You're just a big condescending prick as I am. I want to go to Tara. Tara, how are you doing? You're in Cork.
Hi.
How are you doing, Tara? What do you want to say?
What I want to say is I actually find Tom quite amusing. I don't know if he's still there.
No, he's gone. By now. He's gone. But yeah. Kathy kind of feels the same way, that people shouldn't be, and so does obviously Chapter, people shouldn't be taking advantage of the system.
Yeah, hang on a second. Niall, why is it every time you have this debate about sterilisation and unmarried mothers and these guys will come on and I have three jobs and I'm working 24 hours a day and I don't get to see my kids. Well, I'm afraid he is the same as everybody else. He made choices, bad ones, by the sound of it, really bad ones. And now he wants to take it out on that girl.
I'm sorry, I think we have made very good choices and set very good examples for our children by going out and working and going out and contributing to an economy. And then you've got people with three and four kids subbing off the benefits, off the taxpayers' money, which we pay as taxpayers. Should we as taxpayers not have
nobody seems to say, everyone is talking about unmarried mothers, okay, and that's one topic, right? But there's a lot of money being wasted by our government. You know,
Tara, just detour the debate in a different direction there and blame somebody else. Every time we talk about somebody comes and goes, blame the banks. Throw the banks in there, why don't you as well?
All right, so with the 850 million euros...
Throw the bankers in, throw the bondholders in, throw all them. We're talking about...
Tara, leeches on our benefits.
We're talking about this particular problem tonight. Let's deal with each problem one by one. Not the bankers, not the government, not the whatever it happens to be, the ministers and their pensions. We're talking about this tonight. Let's deal with each individual problem. We talk about all the other problems as well. Let's deal with this one.
I don't agree with her boyfriend being a phone thief. I don't agree with that, Niall. Anyway, I'll say that. I think that's pretty...
Okay,
pretty
well, what disgusting. About what Chapter Jackson is saying? Singer-songwriter, she's expressing her thoughts in music, obviously, that she believes that women should be sterilised after the second child.
I think men should be sterilised after the second child, to tell you the truth, Niall.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm not going to be sexist and say you're wrong, but then again, the problem is it's the women that have the babies, not the men. That's not our fault. It's nature.
That's true.
The men would be a lot more careful, Niall, if the guys were rounded up after they got the girls pregnant and they were brought into a hospital and they were sterilised.
They should be forced to maintain those babies. Yes, I completely agree with you.
I mean, if they were warned, if they were told, if you get your girlfriend pregnant again, we're going to sterilise you, you know, and we'll get a court order to do it. You know, things might change then, Niall.
Yeah, but the problem is...
I agree with that lady from America to a certain degree. You know, I mean, they have the system in China. And it seems to be bringing down the population. I mean, they're at crisis point in China at the moment with overpopulation. I don't know where all this food is going to come out of to feed these people, Niall. know.
Well, hold on for a second. You're talking about China and where's this food going to come from and everything else. If you know, we have the same problem here that they have in many other countries, including the United States, when it comes to welfare dependency. We have 24 billion euro going out in welfare every single year, and the state only takes in something like 22 billion in taxes.
Right. But I mean, I remember this problem when I was in school in the 1980s. Girls getting pregnant all the time.
But it's getting worse, Tara. It's getting worse.
It is getting worse. But the whole problem is responsibility. People not taking responsibility for their lives.
Yeah, why did you have a go with Tom? Tom is out there taking responsibility. Kathy's taking responsibility.
Tom needs to take responsibility. What Tom needs to do is address his own situation. He's taking his problems out on that girl, Niall, which is wrong. And a lot of people do that on your station. They ring up. They've got problems in their own relationships, their own jobs, their own private lives. They ring up and they make a comparison with a stranger on the radio and say, "You're to blame for my problem." That's totally wrong, Niall. And and everyone does it on your radio station all the time.
But the point he's making is that for him to have, an equal living to Tanya, he has to work three jobs because he's not entitled to anything from the state. Tanya is screwing the state for every single benefit she can get.
I think he's blaming Tanya for his problems.
I don't look at it that way. I believe that he realizes he has problems like most people in this country, but I don't think he's blaming Tanya, essentially. I think he's blaming Tanya for the amount of tax that he has to pay. And not just personally Tanya, but people like Tanya who are abusing the system.
He's got to pay a lot of tax now because of the stupid government that's running the country.
Well, then, hold on. The stupid government have to pay. You're blaming the government, right? Okay, the government might be making these benefits available, but if people weren't abusing those benefits, we wouldn't have such a big social welfare bill.
No, you're missing the point. Abusing the system. The government are abusing the system. Look at the way they abuse their privileges in the Dáil. Look at the way they abuse their get free lunches, free petrol, free expenses. Look at the way they abuse all these things, Niall.
I understand that, and I agree with you completely. But again, I'd say to you, let's deal with one problem at a time. We've got the highest income tax rate in Europe, which even Chapter, I'm sure, would be shocked at. In America, I don't know what the income tax rate is, but it's certainly not anywhere close to 41% of your salary going back to the government to pay taxes for people who don't want to work. Sorry, Chapter, you want to say something?
It's 28% here. 28%.
Gosh, that's luxury. That's luxury. The average person in this country probably paying closer to 41%. And on top of that, we got our property taxes, water charges coming in. You've got all sorts of other stealth taxes that we're paying. Why? Because we can't afford to run the country, Tara. Because we've got people in this country, not just the people who find themselves unfortunately out of work. You've got people abusing the system, living on the social welfare.
Right. And we've got politicians doing the exact same. They pretend every day, Niall.
How many politicians
they go to work
37.
And they do something and they contribute.
37.
They don't contribute.
37 politicians in the Dáil. Let's say, worst case scenario, let's say they're scamming 100 grand a year, which they're not. But let's say they are scamming 100 grand a year, all 37 of those. That's still only 37,000 euro. That doesn't make up what we're talking about. We're talking about 24 billion. We're talking about the people today. Tonight, we want to talk about the people and their part in it. So let's be part of the solution and part of the problem.
You're making it very simple, Niall, and it's not like that.
All right, listen, I have to wrap it up. Listen, I got to thank Chapter Jackson for coming on tonight. Listen, Chapter, thank you very much indeed. And if anyone wants to go to YouTube, by the way, you can. I'm not forgetting the name of the song, would you believe? Chapter, remind me the name of the song again there.
It's chapterjackson.com.